Hi, and welcome to my channel. Hogwarts Legacy have arrived, and I see a lot of people having issues with this game, like crashing, freezing, or the game won't launch at all. I took some time to research all these issues, and in this video I will bring you almost all possible solutions for these problems. Be sure to try every solution from this video, and I hope that one will work for you. Before we start, just to remind you to hit that like and thanks button if you fixed your game with the help of this video. And now, let's go with the first method. If you played the game with no problems until now, and this is the first time that the game crashes or won't launch, I would suggest you to restart your PC and try to launch the game. Sometimes simple restart can do miracles. So first restart your PC, launch the game, and if you still have issues, then continue with the next methods. Next, what you will do is to check if you have some pending Windows updates. Click on Start and select Settings. Here, select Update and Security. Click on Check for Updates, and if it offers you any new updates, install them all. After that, restart your PC and run the game. Next is to check if your graphic card driver up to date. Right click on Start and select Device Manager. Expand Display Adapters. Right click on your display adapter and select Update Driver. Select Search automatically for drivers, and if Windows finds any new drivers, it will install them. After that, restart your PC. Sometimes this method will say that you already have best drivers installed, but that's not always the truth. Best way to see if your graphic card have any updates is to go to manufacturer website. Find your graphic card and check for updates. Links to these sites are in video description. I have Nvidia graphic card, so I use Nvidia GeForce Experience software to check that. Launch it and click here on drivers. Then click on check for updates. If there are any new drivers available, click on download, and after that, just follow instructions to install it. Restart your PC after that and launch the game. If you have Intel or AMD graphic card, you can also install their softwares like I did for Nvidia, and install drivers on this way. Next is to set high performance power plan. Click on Start and type Control Panel. Select it up here. To get this kind of interface, click Next to View By and select Large Icon. Now select Power Options. Here, select High Performance Plan. If you don't have it, check in this video description for link to video how to enable it. Next method is to verify game files. Open Steam, find the game, right click on it and select Properties. I don't have Hogwarts Legacy, so as example I will use Apex Legends, but all methods are the same, and you should have no trouble to follow the instructions. Click on Local Files and then click on Verify Integrity of Game Files. This will scan game installation folder, and if there are any corrupted files, it will replace them with new ones, and download any missing files. Just be patient, because this process can take some time, depending on the size of the game. After it finishes, run the game. Next is to run the game as admin. You will come here again and click here on Browse. This will open game installation folder. Find Hogwarts Legacy .exe file. Right click on it and select Properties. Select Compatibility tab up here. Check box next to run this program as administrator. Hit Apply and OK. Now run Steam and launch the game from Steam library. If it won't launch, you can come here and launch game directly from the game .exe file. Sometimes it can do the trick. There is one more option here you can enable. Go to Launcher Properties again, and in Compatibility tab, check this box next to Run this program in Compatibility Mode 4. Select Windows 7. Click Apply and then OK. Some users say that this helped to load the shaders. Launch the game. And if it gives you black screen, just let it go a minute or two, and hopefully it will load all shaders and you are good to go. While you are here, click on empty spot here in address bar, and it will highlight this complete address. Then right-click on it and select copy. This path will need you for the next method. You can now close this window. Next is to set the game to run at high performance graphic. Click on start and type graphic settings. And then select graphic settings up here. If you haven't already, enable hardware accelerated GPU scheduling. Now click down here on browse. When this window opens, click again here on address bar and delete all this. Then right click, select paste and hit enter. This will take you to the game installation folder. Once there, click on Hogwarts Legacy .exe file, like I will do here for Apex, and click on add. Now you will click down here on options, select high performance and then save. Next, right click on start and select run. Type percentage local app data percentage and hit enter. Here, find Hogwarts Legacy folder and open it. Open saved folder. Here, right click on config folder and select rename. Add old at the end and hit enter. Try to launch the game. If it still have issues, then do the same thing for save games folder. Right click, rename and add old. Launch it again and see did it worked. Renaming save game folder will cause you to lose any saved progress. So if it didn't work, you can come back here and delete old. Next thing you will do is perform a clean boot. Right click on start and select run. Type msconfig in search box and hit enter. This window will open and make sure you are on services tab. Check this box where it says hide all Microsoft services. Click here on disable all and then on apply and OK. And it will ask you to restart your Windows. Restart it and launch the game. If you could launch the game normally, it means that some of the programs listed here are interfering with the game and prevent it to launch normally. So if the game launched, you will come here again and enable one by one app from this list. Restart Windows and after that launch the game until you find out what app is causing launch failure. Then you can decide do you want to uninstall it or just disable it to launch with your Windows, so you can start your game with no problems. When you are doing this method, don't launch any other programs you usually launch with your game, like Discord, MSI Afterburner and so on. Let it be clean boot default. Next is to change shader cache value for NVIDIA graphic card. Right click on desktop and select NVIDIA control panel. Select Manage 3D settings. Under General tab, find Shader Cache Size option. Click next to it and from drop-down menu, select Unlimited option. After that, click on Apply to save the settings. And here are some additional options what you can do if none of this worked. If you use any third-party antivirus software, try to temporarily disable it and run the game. Disable all unnecessary programs to run when you play the game, like Discord, Spotify, MSI Afterburner to run next to the game. Don't leave your web browser open, especially multiple tabs, because they are also taking up precious resources from your CPU and GPU, so the game could crash because of that. Be sure that hard drive where the game is installed have enough space. If you are near full, delete something from that drive to free up some space. Also, you can try to disconnect any devices you have connected to your PC and leave only your mouse and keyboard and try to run the game. If none of this method worked, then I suggest you to try to reinstall the game in hope it will fix the problems. And with this, we came to end of this video. Please support me with like button if any of these methods helped you. If you want to buy me a cup of coffee, you can hit thanks button. Subscribe to my channel with the bell on so you don't miss my next video. Until then, stay safe and I see you all.